have some really interesting stories to bring this month.
Yes, so let's get started. Our first story is from Maria, who's been finding out about the holy month of Ramadan.
Let's cross over to Maria.
Hi guys, I'm Maria Fira and I'm back on the Passmores News Channel today to talk to you about the holy month of Ramadan. Now I personally don't know too much about this particular subject, however I'm sure you all know that loads of students in this school are currently celebrating this month. Let's go talk to some students who do know about this and see what they have to say. What is Ramadan?
Ramadan is a holy month for us Muslim people, where we fast from sunrise to sundown, and we do it because we want to feel like how poor people that don't have food or water, to appreciate like all food we have and not waste it or anything like that, and all good you do like are accepted from God, and yeah.
What does Ramadan mean to you?
Self-discipline, self-reflection, and a month of being grateful.
What is Eid?
Eid to me is a part of a Ramadan when you finish 30 days of Ramadan and you do Eid, a celebration with your family, and you go out with them, and you go to pray the day it's Eid for the God to accept your fastings through the Ramadan.
What do you enjoy the most about Eid?
The most I enjoy about Eid is that I go and have dinner with my family and I celebrate with my family.
What is the best part of Ramadan?
The best part of Ramadan for me is like after fasting the whole day, when you like break your fast and you just eat nice food, which we have after like the long day.
So now you know more about Ramadan. I'm Maria Fira. This is the Passmores News Channel. Have a great day. Bye.
Thank you, Maria, Miss Begum, and the students involved in these interviews. We hope that you enjoyed your Eid celebrations this week.
Now we're going to find out about the My Sparta Essex event that happened on the 21st of April.
Here are Hinaeus and Logan to tell us more.
Hi, I'm Logan.
And I'm Hinaeus.
And today we're going to be showing you around the My Smarter Essex event.
So what's going on at this station is we have muffins and binary combined. So if you look over here, binary operates in zeros and ones. So our chocolate muffins equal zero and our plain muffins equal ones. And what we've done in this first little area is we've set out different sequences using the muffins to represent the binary code for the pupils to solve. And if you come over to this side, we've already given you the different numbers here. And with these muffins, you just place them in order in binary code. And this is an example. So what everyone's gonna do is use these different muffins to write the code for these different numbers here. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, it looks like it's pretty amazing. I think Miss Knight has been the person who's put most of it together. And it's like a STEM event, which is like science, technology, engineering, maths, which is good. I'm a maths teacher, which is fantastic. But I think the evening is going to be really good for parents and carers and also our students and other families in Harlow, because basically they're going to learn about, you know, internet safety, how important that is, etc. But also, like, things going on in the future in terms of the internet, because I imagine some of the students who are younger coming to see these events, even you guys, you might be doing a job in 20 years time that doesn't actually exist at the moment. So yeah, that's really exciting, so I'm looking forward to it.
So what's going on at this station?
So this company is called Charles River, and we're a drug discovery company based in Harlow and at Chester Park. So what we have today is some chemistry and biology displays. This is all the chemistry side here, where you can see there's some building blocks, molecules, etc. And in the biology side, we're preparing to do some DNA extraction from strawberries. So if I just show you, we have one prepared already.
Yes.
Sorry, excuse me. So this is one we prepared earlier. And in here you've got the strawberry extract with some buffer. And that white bit you're seeing there, that's the DNA extracted from the strawberry. So here's some protocols that, you know, just simple stuff you can use at home if you wanted to try it at home. And yeah, it's designed to just make it all fun and interactive and show you how much fun science can be.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you to Miss Knight for organising it and to all the people who partaked, who was involved. It was a fantastic evening.
Our final story is from Logan. He's been asking staff what their unpopular opinions are.
Oh wow, this can get heated. Roll the tape.
Let's go and take a look at some of your unpopular opinions.
My unpopular opinion is that I hate roast dinners.
Mm. They're disgusting.
Wow, that's very unpopular. And why, well, why is it, apart from the fact that it's disgusting?
Because I was forced to eat them every Sunday and just the smell of them, I don't like. Meat, no. Vegetables, not really. Lots of gravy, no. No, there's a lot about them I don't like.
Have you got anything to say about that?
Well, see, I also agree with her.
Because so do
I moved to this country and was like, what is this big obsession with roast dinners? They're not that nice.
Gross.
Yorkshire pudding, it shouldn't have a pudding in it. Like, I moved here thinking that was a dessert and I was massively fooled. All this like dough just comes out with a bunch of gravy in it. No. So I agree with hers, and I also do not like cake. I hate cake. I'm just not a fan. I eat it when people get it for me for my birthday, but other than that,
that's
no.
It's not even a thing. How can somebody not like cake?
Okay, I don't like cake either. I didn't have cake at my birthday or anything, so
yeah.
I don't like cake.
And to be fair, I'm allergic to half of the cakes, so already, you know, they could kill me.
That's a really unpopular opinion, though. Cake's lovely.
So my unpopular opinion is that barbecue food is highly and completely overrated.
Why?
Right, okay, I get that, you know, 2% of the time you get a good barbecue food, right? If someone's good on the barbie, you're going to get decent food. But 99% of the time, and I'm aware that maths doesn't add up, barbecue food just tastes like the barbecue it's been cooked on.
Well, I sort of agree with you, but what about the atmosphere and stuff? You know, I do love the atmosphere of a nice sunny day and a good barbecue.
Okay, yeah, I agree. Right, the barbecue food is the key here. The atmosphere of a barbecue can be class, okay? Especially
class.
If it's absolutely class.
Yeah.
Especially if it's a sunny day. Yeah. Maybe you got a football, maybe you got a frisbee, you got some tunes on.
Frisbee.
Yeah. Allow that.
I'm offended.
Right.
I'll allow it.
Okay, yeah. If you've got the tunes on, nice day, you're with family and friends. But like I say, if you haven't got a good chef on the barbie, it's going to taste like the barbecue it's cooked on.
So we'd just like to wish Jackie a very, very happy birthday.
I think custard cream is the best biscuit.
I completely disagree, and I think bourbon is the better biscuit.
But it's not even like it's good chocolate. It's like sand that's been compacted.
Chocolate. But chocolate is chocolate. Like, how can you?
It's chocolate isn't chocolate. Because if you put chocolate off the floor, it's not just chocolate, is it? It's chocolate off the floor.
It's still chocolate.
And that's essentially what
bourbon
is.
No. Like, you're literally, why would you want a biscuit that tastes of nothing? It's nothing. It's got no flavour to it. It has no flavour.
It literally is in the name. It's literally custard.
It doesn't taste like custard, though, does it? Because custard is grim. Custard is like slodge.
Custard is not slodge. This is solidified. I don't know if you know what a biscuit looks like.
She just can't take it when other people don't like her opinions.
Staying in the UK is a fabulous thing to do, and I don't really think that, like, with the lockdown and COVID and not being able to go abroad, I didn't really see that as much of a problem.
Really?
The UK is beautiful, fabulous, fantastic coastlines, fantastic varied scenery, so much culture to learn about, and people should try to experience it and enjoy it rather than worrying about what the rest of the world is like. Although, as a geography teacher, I'd just like to say exploring the world is a great thing too, but I don't see the problem with UK holidays.
Right.
Okay then. I think many people will disagree with you there, to be honest.
You think that's unpopular?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think people want to stay in this country. You can never even guarantee the weather or anything.
Well, there's no such thing as bad weather, just bad choice of clothing. Yes.
Right, okay, that's also unpopular.
Are you really ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is what I think. Yeah, so that's like how Mr. Faye came to have that nickname.
Wow. I don't know if we can put that in. Can we actually put
Was
that in?
Is it that bad, you reckon?
I don't know. Jack, should we put it in?
I don't know. I don't think that could go in.
Well, my unpopular opinion is that I find Mr. Pickering quite interesting.
Why?
He's just got a lot to say and he's very interesting.
Yeah. Why is that unpopular?
Because oh, that was.
So why is that unpopular then?
You need to ask the rest of the humanities department.
Now I do know that Miss Cunningham, you wanted to say something about holidays, didn't you, to me as well? So where do you like to go on holidays?
Anywhere hot.
Yeah. And,
so I disagree.
Disagree. And I have no desire to go to Las Vegas or Dubai, which Miss Cunningham thinks is an unpopular thing to say.
Smartphones, the internet and anything to do with that should all be destroyed. We should go back to time before these things existed. That's my unpopular opinion.
Wow, he's a bit of a boomer, isn't he? Well, so why do you think this then? What is the reason behind it?
Well, I didn't feel that I'd satisfactorily completed the 20th century before the 21st century had come. There's still quite a lot of poetry I had to get through. And I really think that these machines here that you're recording me on are just a distraction.
Wow. Very bold.
Yes, we hope so. Well, this is all we have time for this month from us at Passmores. Goodbye.